Glenn and Heather Singleman are about to take the biggest leap of their lives.
We're as ready as I think anybody could be.
They're at 28,000 feet. The air's so thin they need oxygen tanks to survive. And their mission? Fly across the Grand Canyon. On the cue of one small green light, they will attempt what no one has ever done, with only their wingsuits and their wits to survive. It's now or never.
Now, did that seem a little scary to anyone?
All of you.
Well, with no understanding of what's involved in making something like that happen, you can really only respond from fear, untempered by reason or logic or emotion or training. But you know, I'm fascinated by that fear. I mean, what is fear? Where is it in our brain? How does it affect our lives? And more importantly, how can we overcome it? Because we all experience fear. In fact, I believe fear is the main reason that people don't achieve their full potential in terms of health, happiness, and success.
So what do you think? Could anyone make that jump?
Yes!
No, you're all thinking like me, right? No way. And more importantly, why would you want to? Why would anyone want to do that? But as Glenn spoke to us that day, he had some really interesting points about fear, about how the brain works and about how it's segmented into different parts and that those parts often conflict.
And today we're going to look at the process behind living brave, the process of developing discipline, focus, skill and passion. Now, to put all this into context, I need to tell you a bit more about myself. I'm actually a doctor of emergency medicine and an expedition filmmaker and a world record holding extreme sportsman. That seems like an unusual combination of skills, but I believe that being an adventure sportsman has helped me be a better doctor, because adventure sport has taught me the value of teamwork. It's taught me the value of fearlessness. It's taught me how to develop self-confidence, resilience, self-efficacy, courage. And I know that you don't need to be an extreme sports person to develop these skills. There are a simple set of physical and mental techniques that anybody can use to literally live brave.
Fear makes us weak. Fear, nerves, anxiety, stress, bad thoughts, the inability to control our mind, all those things rob us of our true potential for happiness, to be the best we can be. And so I went to find how I could turn this around. And in the end, I started by making a commitment to myself, and a commitment to Glenn, that I would own this 100% in my heart, that I would be personally responsible for my thinking, for my planning, for my checking of gear. And by doing that, by taking 100% responsibility, by committing myself, then providence moves too. And it moved in some really interesting ways for me, but the first of which was coming up with a way to take my mind back from the fear, to transform myself. And it was this combination of mental techniques that I used then and that I still use now for every project that we undertake. I come back to this. So I practice it daily, but I come back to it really strongly before we do anything big. And it's a combination of techniques incredibly powerful for transforming our mind. I got my mama.